Now at 6, state representatives want answers about why the prison system can't hire or keep corrections guards. Good evening, I'm John Madden, in for Jennifer Griswold. The Department of Corrections says they're on emergency staffing, so guards have to work 12-hour shifts, so they're increasing hiring bonuses. Senior reporter Jake Wozakowski looks at why and if lawmakers think bonuses are the solution.
A prison lockdown not necessarily for violence. Major staffing issues is stopping inmates from being allowed visits, taking away rec time, and keeping them in cells about 3 hours longer a day at Nebraska's three largest prisons, the State Pen, Tecumseh, and LCC. Director Scott Frakes declares a staffing emergency since guards are quitting because they have to work a lot of overtime and the job demands are too much. Friday, he faces the State Judiciary Committee.
Over the last 7 months, NSP has experienced increased turnover, losing 70 protective services staff.
Vice President of the State Fraternal Order of Police, Matt Barral, says enough is enough. He says state prison officers are paid $2.50 an hour less than officers at the Douglas and Sarpy County jails. He adds the safety of prison guards is being put at risk and they're being assaulted, targeted by prison gangs.
Now they're required to bring in the National Guard because they just don't have enough corrections officers. And this has been time and time again where they're slapping a Band-Aid on an arterial bleed.
Frakes says a $10,000 bonus is being offered to new hires, but it will be spread out over 3 years.
For the new hire, you are competing against the county jails.
Not really. I know that's the mythology, but it's not really true.
I don't know how you get there without bumping up the hourly rate so that you can compete in the labor market and bring people in. I don't know how these bonuses get that done.
Senator Ernie Chambers worries making inmates stay in their cells longer, taking away visits and rec time, could lead to more attacks on each other and the staff.
That would result in the type of pressure that would manifest itself in discipline problems.
Frakes says he hopes to lift the emergency staffing declaration and get rid of those 12-hour mandatory shifts in less than 6 months. Reporting in Lincoln, Jake Wozakowski, 3 News Now.